soon we will listen to two more stories of two doctors who became municipal health officers in two poor municipalities, two of the poor municipalities in our country. We will listen this afternoon to the stories of Alan Evangelista, who was assigned in Katigbian, Bohol as a Leaders for Health doctor, and Pretzel Patrocinio Tolentino, who was assigned in Dinagat Islands as the Municipal Health Officer of that municipality. The process of this afternoon session will run as follows. We will listen to the stories. They will converse with each other and to you and tell their stories. And then we will open the floor for comments or questions or clarifications from the audience. Then we will wrap up the session with a short synthesis and again proceed to the booths and to the synthesis downstairs, no, in the auditorium. So we begin this afternoon session, and we'd like again to welcome all of you and thank you for coming to this story. Thank you.
Good afternoon. My name is Pretzel Tolentino. You can call me Doc Pretz. I graduated from Pamantasan ng Lungsod ng Maynila. After passing the board exam, I took up a residency training in pediatrics at Ospital ng Maynila. After 6 months of residency training, I became frustrated. I thought I wanted to help kids, I want to help children, but in the hospital, I realized that you only treat them when they're in the hospital. So it's like a vicious cycle, like diarrhea, you just hydrate them in the hospital, and after a few weeks, they come back again with the same problem. So maybe it's not really treating the disease. So I realized that there could be something more that I can do. So after 6 months, I resigned. And then after while looking for other options, I just accompanied my then boyfriend who was applying for Doctor Sudabario. I just accompanied him for his interview. So during it was an interview for the LHP program. I didn't know anything about the LHP program until that day. During that interview, I was supposed to be just a supporter, but I ended up being interviewed as well. So I did not file any application, but they interviewed me anyway. So I ended up joining the LHP. And after the interview, it was the orientation. So during the orientation, it was only that time that I knew about the LHP program. I thought it was just going into the barrios, like the doctors to the barrio thing. But it was something more. The program was a four-year program, which earns you a master's degree afterwards. And it just not involves the doctors, but it also involves the mayors and two community leaders. So it means that the mayors and the community leaders will also take up courses in community health management. And the doctors will have a degree in community health management as well. So yeah. That's the LHP program. So 2 weeks before we were deployed in our area, that's the only time we knew where we will be deployed. So 2 weeks before, they told me that you will be assigned in Dinagat Islands. So where is that? I just searched it, and I found that it's on the northern part of Mindanao. So in Caraga region. So that's Dinagat Islands. I was assigned in Dinagat Municipality. It's a fifth class municipality. So it's an island municipality. Yes, 12 barangays, and 3 of those barangays are small islands, island barangays. Okay, so tulikan na. So upon arrival at the areas, upon arrival at the area, you'll notice this is a poor community. So it was never taught in medical school that when we arrive at the rural health unit, it was never thought that we will be the managers in that in the rural health unit. So, ang dadatnan mo doon ay mga staff na demotivated. So, before I came kasi, they told me that the municipality was doctor-less for 2 years. And the previous doctor retired at 65 years old. The previous doctor has been there for about 20 years or so. And meron na siyang mga practices na nandun na sa mga tao na pagka may sakit, may ubo, bibigyan agad ng antibiotics. So, ganun yung practice noon na na-propagate na sa mga tao na, pag may ubo, may nagtataek, kotray mo ka sa soul agad. So, alam na nung mga tao kung ano yung bibigay kasi dahil matanda na siya, hindi na siya masyadong nagko-consult. So, pag dumating doon, kung ano yung gamot na nandoon, bibigay na lang niya. So, nasanay yung mga tao ng ganon. And this doctor was also a chain smoker and an alcoholic drinker. Even at inside the RH, talaga nagsusmoke siya. So, matagal na siya doon at yun yung nakikita ng mga tao. And then, yung mga RHU staff naman, ang dinatnan ko doon, puro demotivated staff. Kasi hindi pa sila naka-recover from the trauma of devolution. So, doon sa devolution kasi, before it was centralized from DOH, everything was provided for them. Dati, lahat na supplies coming from DOH, diretso sa kanila. So, during devolution, everything was passed on to the LGU. At ang laging sasabihin ng mga staff, we cannot do anything na kasi there's no budget na eh. Kasi sa ano na eh, sa LGU na lahat eh. So, ganun sila. So, they're thinking that there's nothing more can be done because there's no budget. So, yun lang yung naging dahilan nila. And aside from that, the people, nasanay na sila ng dole out palagi, nasanay na sila na self-medication, nasanay na sila na antibiotics for everything. So, yun ang dinatnan ko doon sa area. So, yun. So, dinaga. So, how about you, Alan?
Okay. Sige, Pretch. Thank you. Magka-batch kasi kami ni Dr. Pretchel, no? We belong to the second batch ng Leaders for Health program together with Dr. Leia Drun Salvatera there sitting. Ako naman, I graduated 1999. MD sa FEU Nicanor Reyes Memorial Foundation and passed the boards 2000, so Millennium Doctor kami. No, I joined LHP after my residency training in pediatrics in Makati Medical Center. So may training na ako sa pediatrics pero hindi ako pumasok sa private practice. I immediately entered into government service, no, as a medical officer in Oriental Mindoro. Medical officer 4 and medical officer 5. No, one duty na naka-off ako, I went back in Manila and saw an advertisement for doctor volunteers for the Leaders for Health program. So just like Dr. Pretch, pumunta ako dun sa interview and orientation. There I learned na maganda yung program kasi you will earn a master's degree. Just like what she said, no? Pero yung orientation namin would be very superficial na you'll be assigned somewhere in the far-flung areas in the country. Sa akin, napunta ako sa Katigbian, Bohol. And during the orientation, we're given some highlights ng mga issues na nakapalob dun sa pupuntahan naming area, particularly sa akin. Ang sinabi lang sa akin, medyo magulo yung health system nila doon kasi meron ng ongoing na problem. Demotivated din yung staff kasi pinaglalaban nila yung Magna Carta benefits ng public health workers. No, so yun lang ang binigay sa akin, particularly na hint kung ano yung mga work na dapat kong gawin doon sa area. Pero when I came sa Katigbian, Bohol, it's in the Central Visayas area, so Region 7. So maganda kasi Region 7 tapos tourist destination Bohol, pero may town Katigbian is situated in the interior. So